Today, we will see about industries of Karnataka. What do you mean by industries? Okay, you are right. Industries are those places where the raw materials are processed. And these raw materials, we get it from agriculture and all the other primary economic activities. So let's start the lesson. In this chapter, we will learn about the industrial development in the Karnataka state. We will talk about the major industries in Karnataka and what are the significance. We will mainly talk about Bangalore, India's main IT center. IT stands for information technology. We will talk about knowledge-based companies. And lastly, we will speak about the major industrial regions of Karnataka. Let us just quickly see how was the industrial development of Karnataka. Growth of industries plays a huge important role in the development of any state. Now why do you think, why industries are so important? Industries help in giving employment to all the people. Industries again help, if you have seen, in the growth of country's economical progress. What is a brief history of Karnataka's industry? Let us start from there. Although we know that economy was completely primarily based on agriculture, the mining industry was still prevalent in the northern part of Karnataka. Since you can talk about like 4th century to 10th century. There was a flourishing textile and shipping industry during the Hoysalas period. I think regarding the Hoysalas, you all would have heard or read in your history. During the period of 14th century to 16th century, under the Vijayanagara Empire, I think Vijayanagara Empire we all know, right? Krishnadev Rai and Tenali Rama. There was a vibrant textile industry. Shipbuilding industry also prospered as the empire had many numbers of ports and there was a high quality of iron and steel exports also from Karnataka. The industrial development of Karnataka. Now, there are a few factors which help in the industrial development of Karnataka. Let's see. First one, for industries we need raw materials and mainly the minerals. So Karnataka has abundance of mineral resources. Again, for any industry, water is a primary factor needed to cool down the machines. So Karnataka has a huge good source of sufficient water. Then, if the industry needs to flourish, we need good transport system for transporting the goods, let it be the unfinished or the finished goods. Karnataka again has a good transport system. Wide market. Again, once the goods are manufactured, we need a place where we can sell all these goods. So Karnataka again has a huge wide scope of having a wide market. Ideal climatic condition. We all know. Karnataka is having a very ideal. Again, in industries, we need labors. We need skilled as well as unskilled. So in Karnataka, we have the skilled labor. And lastly, the modern technology. So Karnataka is having all the favorable factors needed to set up an industry. Let us see about the industrial development of Karnataka. I think we all have heard about Sir M. Vishveshwaraya, who is popularly called as Sir MV. He was an engineer, a very eminent statesman and a very, very famous scholar. He made remarkable contribution in the growth and development of all the industries of Karnataka. His motto was industrialize or perish. I think we all know what is the meaning of the word perish. And this led to the foundation of many important industries in the state of Karnataka. The other few important contributions done by Sir M. Vishveshwaraya, he was responsible for the founding of many important institutions like your Mysore soap factory. We all have either used or seen the Mysore sandal soap. He had a huge hand regard that. Mysore Iron and Steel Works, which is now called as Vishveshwaraya Iron and Steel Limited. The State Bank of Mysore, which has branches across India. It was again the contribution goes to Sir M.V. Then the Century Club, Mysore Chamber of Commerce. So he has done a huge contribution. Sir M.V. also had a huge major contribution in designing the automatic barrier for water floodgates so that to avoid the flooding. In 1955, conquered to him. And if you all know, September 15th is celebrated as your Engineers' Day. It is as a mark of tribute given to him. Let us continue. The industrial development of Karnataka. After the hydroelectric power generation started at Shivasamudra in 1902, many industries producing essential goods and products for daily use were established, such as your rice mills, your tile factories, your beads, your cigarettes, and iron and brass foundries. So this was the first and prominent major development stage of Karnataka industrial development. In 1923, many modern manufacturing units such as iron and steel, soap factories, cotton mills, silk mills, paper, cement, paint, sugar, sandal oil industries started. So slowly the industrial development had started in Karnataka. The pre-independence era, that is before 1947, Mysore as a province was a model state with respect to industries. The main reason was the interest taken by the Mysore kings and the British. After independence, the industrialization policy of the central government enabled the further growth of industries in the Karnataka state. So Karnataka was very prominent in industries, let it be pre-independence or post-independence era. As a result of these industrial growth, many modern industries were established in the state, like starting with manufacture of aeroplanes, engineering, machine tools. If you have seen HMT, BEL and Bell, iron and steel, aluminium, IT and electronic biotechnology. So today in Karnataka, the industries are ranging from agricultural-based small-scale industry to huge modern large-scale industries like your information technology. If you all know, Bangalore is called as the IT capital of India. It's also referred as the Silicon Valley of India. Because of the tremendous growth in the IT sector, information technology, the prominent IT firms, if you all know, like Infosys, Wipro, everything has a headquarters in Karnataka. Today, Bangalore is the hub of IT and biotechnology industry. Karnataka is one of the leading industrial states of India, holding the fifth highest GDP. What is GDP? GDP stands for Gross Domestic Product, ranking among all the Indian states. Just a few extra information. Bangalore, which is the capital of Karnataka, it is an IT hub and the fourth largest technology cluster in the world. Karnataka has 23 operational IT sectors, 5 software technology parks and many investment regions. Bangalore is also referred as at times as the government capital of India. It has a vibrant automobile, agro, aerospace, textiles, biotech and heavy engineering industries. A quick summary today what we have done. Industries play a very vital role in the development of the state. Our state, that is Karnataka, has had the opportunity to set up various industries due to many favorable conditions, or you can tell factors. Several other factors helped to speed up the industrialization of Karnataka under the eminent leadership of Sir M. Visveshwaraya. An interest was shown by the Mysore kings and the British in the kingdom's development. Establishment of hydroelectric power generation in the state and later the industrialization policy of the Union government. As a result, it has led in establishment of many industries in the Karnataka state, starting from your iron and steel, soap factories, that is your Mysore sandal prominently, cotton and silk mills, paper industry, cement industry, sugar industry, and few modern industries like manufacturing of aeroplanes, engineering, machine tools, IT and electronic biotechnology. Today, Karnataka is a major hub for information technology as well as biotechnology industry. Karnataka is a leading industrial state of India, holding the fifth highest GDP ranking among all the Indian states. Students, this is the homework. I hope that you all will be able to answer it. Thank you.